Look closer. In the shadows, behind the everyday world, beyond the headlines and the seats of power, a hidden hand. A kind of company known as Providence. To it, we were just assets to use and throw away, to do the unthinkable, the unforgivable. And it never gave us a second thought until now. After decades in the shadows, we are fighting back. Me and 47. Much has been lost, but we are closer than ever. We trapped the Constant, Providence's chief controller, and finally learnt the names of its three partners. In their downfall, we lay the past to rest. And, just maybe, look towards the future.
47. It's time. Partners are down there. You know, I never planned this far ahead.
You never do.
I see someone got his memory back. Wait, is that a beacon? What the hell? Base, Alexa Carlisle's helicopter just took off. Confirmed target locations, over.
Diana, what's the status?
Right. We have a situation. Carlisle has left the building. And I think I know why. The Constant has escaped. He persuaded one of the sailors into setting him free. And since then, he's been seizing control of Providence assets and resources. I can only assume Carlisle is rushing to contain the damage.
If she slips away again...
We'll keep track of her. Make sure she doesn't. Meanwhile, the plan stays the same. Your destination is the Scepter, the world's tallest building where the partners are laying low, courtesy of their host, Sheikh Omar al-Ghazali. Marcus Stuyvesant is fifth-generation old money. His family made its fortune in real estate and banking, and were at one point the chief landowners in New York. Carl Ingram is a powerful Washington kingmaker whose family grew rich selling gunpowder during the American Civil War and later established a globe-spanning empire in oil, coal, and steel. Both families long since retreated from public view, but their quiet dominance endures to this day. Now, the partners likely suspect that we're coming, so Mr. Gray will infiltrate building controls and disable all electronic doors and elevators. Stuyvesant and Ingram are about to find they have nowhere left to run.
Right. This is our moment, 47. Providence ruined our lives with the flick of a pen. Today, we return the favor. Happy hunting.
Welcome to Dubai, 47. Today is the inauguration of the Scepter, and the ceremony is well underway. You will find Marcus Stuyvesant near the building's signature art installation. While a paranoid Carl Ingram has ensconced himself in his penthouse suite, security on highest alert. Mr. Gray is already in position and ready to assist. Good luck, 47.
47. Come in, 47. Do you copy?
I'm here.
Are you in position?
I'm heading towards the point of entry.
Good. Get back to me when you're there. Use your camera and scan the lock, will you? I think I can override the window's controls from here.
I'm in position.
47, the inauguration is taking place close by. Once you've infiltrated it, get your bearings. I'm sure there must be floor plans somewhere.
Understood.
We need absolute focus on this one. If Ingram and Stuyvesant are alerted to our presence, we may lose them for good. We are so close, 47.
Don't worry. They're not going anywhere.
On behalf of His Royal Highness Omar al-Ghazali, I bid you welcome to the city.
So someone came in here to steal something.
Welcome!
Welcome.
Hello!
Good to see you. How lovely to see so many familiar faces here today. This has been a dream of mine for 3 years. And as all of you, I am from one of the less privileged sides of a respectable al-Ghazali family. But with a small loan from my father, I soon built up a construction empire that was worthy of the great al-Ghazali legacy. So, I would like to thank my cousins, without whose friendship and influence this achievement.
Thank you. I'm proud to yet again immortalize our great family today. But most of all, this building is all of the people. Just today, the tallest building in the world.
Probably still down at the depot, getting his uniform. I just hope he's got his papers with him. I heard rumors that he used to work for that Dawood Rangan. You know, the Bollywood producer who died?
Doesn't sound promising.
Nope, it doesn't.
Stuyvesant is expecting a replacement guard. If you can locate him,
We should be able to get within strangling distance of the little worm.
I got no visual on target, Command. I think we're in the clear.
Is anyone there? Who made that sound?
Sweet!
I have a problem. I'm supposed to meet up for duty, but they can't find my uniform.
That's not my problem.
Come on, I need help. You look my size. If you're off duty, couldn't I just borrow your uniform? It's fine.
I don't know you. You who?
Oh, yeah.
Hello, I don't mean to pry, but upstairs, do you by any chance know who's staying there?
Reporting for duty.
About time. Our client has been going out of his mind waiting for you. Do you have the papers?
Yes.
Good. I'll call him now.
How should I address him?
It's classified, so you don't call him anything. But officially, he's just known as codename Pinky. Sir, this is security. Just calling to let you know your new guard has finally arrived. Yes, sir. See you soon. Well, this is awkward. Okay, wait here. He'll be here shortly.
Okay, you must be my new escort.
Right there, that's Marcus Stuyvesant, Providence partner, self-entitled and arrogant little worm. He might not look like much, but he's done more damage to the world than you could dream.
Let me see here. Yes, that looks good. I like it. A cutlery expert, no less. I have no idea what that means. But your CV is very impressive. This looks perfect. Okay, walk with me. I need to go through some ground rules. I expect you to be by my side 24/7, unless I say otherwise. Bathroom breaks are, of course, permitted, but only when I say so. I have a very important, delicate meeting today, in which I expect you to keep your ears closed, but your eyes wide open. Understood? Now. Your papers were indeed impressive, but I need to see what you can do with my own eyes. My father used to take me hunting. He was an avid hunter. I personally hated it, but always admired his skill with a knife, and grew to appreciate what it takes to gut an animal. Have you ever tried to gut an animal?
Yes.
Good. Then you know it's not so easy as it looks. Like trying to stab a rubber ball. It bounces back if you don't stab it correctly.
I feel bad about that.
You're almost here. You have to understand. I didn't get to where I am by blind faith. Okay, we are almost there. You see the shooting targets? Any fool can shoot a target. With a knife? That's where the talent lies. My father always used to say, if you are good with a knife, you're even better with a gun. I want to see your skills. I don't know why, but I've always trusted a man who would throw a knife. I'm sure a psychiatrist would have a field day with that statement. So, show me what you got. Well, and you work for me. Fail, you get out of here, and I never want to see your face again. It's just obvious, half as good as you were.
Only time will tell. But I doubt
it. You cocky idiot. That was quite spectacular.
To do with all that power.
Take the rest of the day off. You deserve it.
Thank you, sir. It was an honor. Thank you, sir.
You impressed me. You really did. But let's get to work. Some things you should know about me, and this is very much on a need-to-know basis. I'm here incognito. So...
You got him, 47. Marcus Stuyvesant won't be a problem anymore. Let's move on to Carl Ingram. We're not done yet.
Excuse, don't do it!
closer.
Trust, no. I cannot emphasize that enough. Don't trust anyone. Okay, that's enough for now.
But I like listening to the radio. Our Royal Highness has never complained about it before.
I'm sorry, but Mr. Ingram, who is the Royal Highness's guest, has requested...
That's Carl Ingram, Provident's partner and brass-balled billionaire. A legendary political fixer, Ingram is old money and as rotten as they come.
And I'll probably get a warning about that.
Get an alert. We both swipe our cards. Bingo.
Okay. Come in, love.
Where was I?
Well, it's time.
History of the partners.
Run down and activate the other swipe as well.
As my successor, it's important you understand that. Who has taken it upon ourselves to guide the world to being a better place, a place where the intelligent and the strong can prosper. But we also understand that where there are masters, there must be servants. It cannot be done without an effective class system. Servants must be controlled.
Not bad. I need a break. That's enough for now. Wonder if there are any other blood-sucking journalists down there. All those ants down there. Most of them wouldn't be here if it wasn't for us. Little do they know that there's a war going on. It's on. So, it's our duty to keep the world in check, to make sure the engine runs smoothly and does not dissolve into anarchy. And that might sound harsh, but it is our fundamental belief that the masses must be guided.
What was it he wanted again?
They are incapable of guiding themselves. However, these ideals could be misinterpreted as some form of dictatorship, and this is... ...is where I beg to differ. Okay, that's enough for now.
Hell of a uniform you got there, guy.
Assume that power can be kept by only a few good men, and women. We might be the chessmen, but we need our chess pieces to keep the balance. Like all the great chess masters of our time, patience is the key. This is the fundamental rule when recruiting.
Hey, who are you? Hey!
You're gonna regret it!
Hello.
A lonely boy came from a less than modest home, chose death.
Please, spare me!
I need assistance! Escort the principal away from here! Blaine, I would like to share...
Okay, need a drink. Thank you.
How are you, sir?
Thank you.
It's our duty to, keep the world in check, to make sure the engine runs smoothly, not dissolve into anarchy. That might sound harsh. It is our fundamental belief that, that the masses must be guided, as they are incapable of guiding themselves. However, these ideals could be misinterpreted as some form of dictatorship, and this is where I beg to differ. We are anything but, which is also why it is imperative that we, the partners, maintain our clandestine approach. The masses like to be led, but the trick is to fool them into thinking that they're not.
That's enough for now. Time for a drink. I think I'm gonna be sick.
Wow.
Hey, you okay? You should go see a doctor or something.
Local cuisine working out for you?
Wow.
Whoa, please don't!
Jeez.
Oh, crap.
Okay.
Ugh. Keep your distance.
We got him, 47. Soon there will be no more Providence. You need to find an exit. Our business is done here, but it's far from over.
that's your winning face, I'd hate to see you lose.
We underestimated the Constant.
Yeah, he's a glorified desk clerk.
He's not just after the money. He wants it all.
We caught him once, we can do it again. And, well, we're not the ones who let him escape.
You still don't trust her.
I don't like executive decision makers. Look, you don't have to follow her, you know? Soon, this will be over. Maybe it's time to think about the future. You have to face the possibility that there's no going back. If the ICA knows what you did,
she'll make it right. She always does.
We have a fix on Carlisle. Come on. We've got a plane to catch. I hope you like the rain, 47.
Miss Burnwood.
How did you...
I have everyone's number. You really ought to know by now.
You planned this. All of it.
Don't be silly. I just played the hand I was dealt.
We'll find you.
You had me. Where'd that get you?
We handed you an empire.
It's for the best. The partners were complacent, set in their ways. But power is more than just security. Providence can be an agent of change. Surely you understand. Or you will. Soon enough.
Welcome to New York, 47. The Milton Fitzpatrick Bank is open for business, but it seems there's some sort of investigation underway. Expect increased security. Your target, Director Athena Savalas, can be found in her top floor office, overlooking the iconic Teller Hall. Head of security, Mateo Perez, is roaming between the vault area and the Teller Hall, talking to employees. And head of accounts, Fabian Mann, can be found on the investment banker floor and the top floor of the bank, driving the internal investigation. Remember, we need to secure the data from the bank's reinforced vault, or, alternatively, acquire 3 hard drives carried by the director and her 2 lieutenants, Mann and Perez. Good luck, 47.
Okay, bye.
say, aren't you Ruby Red? I love the fact that we're there on the money talk data of you. I mean, wow. Jason Portman must hate you.
Sir, if you want to come through, I'm gonna have to pat you down.
I work in insurance.
This'll just take a sec, sir.
No, I'm just not who you think I am, sir. Now.
Okay, let's go, sir. Thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry. You really look like her.
This is the Vault 47. The data core should
really
be behind
sorry,
that large steel door.
The head of security suspects there may have been some tampering going on here.
But I need my things in there.
Done before closing time. Again, I'm really sorry for my grip coming down here. I'm not taking any.
I have no idea what I'm doing. Just hope this works. Gotta conserve that energy. This'll be fixed in no time. Flip it. You're on, baby.
Again.
Great work, 47. You now have access to the vault. Good work, 47. That's the evidence secured for now. Careful not to lose it. If anyone sees you with that rack, my guess is you'll draw a lot of unwanted attention to yourself.
I bet he's seen some action.
Hey, maintenance had a look at the deposit box room camera. Broken one.
Yeah, Fred fought someone down there himself.
Damn.
This is too risky. This could get real messy.
Whoa, slow down. I heard Ruby Red is in the house.
Who?
The journalist. You must have heard about her. She's Miss Exposé.
Never heard of her.
Well, all I can say, if she's here, we are all in big trouble. I mean, this girl makes Nancy Drew seem like a slob. Seriously, if she's here...
Nothing to report.
Yeah, me neither.
Please come to the director's office. I feel like giving that bit... woman a piece of my mind. I gave this place everything.
Don't get restless.
Myself disappear.
As fast as you can.
Just supposed to let anyone from IT in there?
That's right. You know how crap this old building is with the wireless. Now the director hates seeing cables anywhere? Well, she had a router installed in her office, but it dies a lot. Hence a need for IT to drop.
That expression's perfect. Shows them you mean business.
I don't really feel comfortable.
That's right. You know how crap this whole building is. Why?
Look at them down there, scurrying about in their miserable little lives, never accomplishing anything of importance. Sad.
Mr. Franklin, it's Director Savalas from the New York branch. I'm returning a call from Jonathan Luther. I see. Any idea as to when he might be available? I understand the board wanted to perform some sort of review here. I am at a loss as to the details, however. Very well. Then I will wait for his call. It would be a benefit to me to understand the intricacies of the visit. Which files to find in the archives, or even an indication of the extent of the review. It would require some time to prepare for a visit. Thank you, Mr. Frank. I'll await his call.
Stop! Right! You will die today!
That's not... Huh?
Come on! Shoot that...
Oh, have we talked to everyone?
No, I think I saw him going to the bathroom.
Mr. Anderson's price. I want to expand.
Doesn't sound promising. Yeah, we'll give him the benefit of the doubt. Let me know when he comes out.
Will do.
Thank you.
Hi, it's me. Yeah, it went really well.
Wait here. If you hear gunshots, run like crazy.
Okay,
yeah, okay, I'll take the answer.
Olivia has found something interesting. I'll tell you on the way.
Where are we going?
To Paradise, 47.
Welcome to Miami, 47. The innovation race is on its last day, and it is down to the wire. Thousands of eager fans are gathered for the final laps of this unexpectedly close race. Sierra Knox is expertly piloting her red Kronstadt car. Her father, Robert Knox, roams the nearby expo building where Kronstadt is showcasing its new prototype car. The Kronstadt RK Mark III has seen fierce competition from the Chinese Kowloon Heavy Industries' new racer. Moses Lee, CEO of Kowloon, has taken a dominant lead and looks invincible. Sierra Knox will need to risk it all if she wants to win for the third year in a row. The stakes are as high as they can get.
She has an interest in the power. I mean, like,
Oh.
That is Ted Mendez, one of the country's most influential military-grade money men. This must be connected to Kronstadt.
I may only be a tech reporter, but I have ambitions too, you know. The fact is that Kronstadt is very like it.
Mr. Mendez, good.
Joy, sir.
Collecting pictures of celebrity entrepreneurs now, 47? What are you thinking?
Mr. Mendez? Right this way, sir.
Story like that on my first run.
Dream on, pal.
Looking good, man. Looking
Hello,
good.
HR? Yes, it's Finn Wheeler down at the Bayside Center. Listen, I realize this may sound trivial, but the Fountain View soda dispenser has been on the fritz since we moved in. I can't work without my energy drinks, and I have been forced to bring my own.
Well, yes, that's right. But here's the problem.
It's right in here, Mr. Mendez.
Ah, Ted, good to finally see you.
Hello
yes,
there, sir.
Traffic was rough. Ah, never mind. Let me show you everything. I'm gonna say something provocative now, Ted. War is going out of fashion. It's dirty, it's just plain bad PR. Nobody wants to exchange their children and loved ones for flags and medals anymore. The glory is gone, Ted. But luckily, Kronstadt has a solution for that. Imagine this. Android infiltrators operating in the field, disguised and fully embedded, ready to strike at a moment's notice. Indestructible robotic operators who can infiltrate the deepest sanctuary of any adversary, striking an unseen fatal blow, a surgical tool for a blunt world. Imagine an army of them. Fully equipped android medics seeking out wounded servicemen and injured civilians, bringing them to safety or patching them up then and there. Android pilots delivering payloads deep inside enemy territory with uncanny precision and minimal collateral damage. All right, Mendez, it's very straightforward. Let me show you. I just pick any of the pictures on the desk, then I use the scanner to upload the biometric data, and Pallas will do the rest.
Target acquired. Dummy B.
Obviously, the final system won't rely on you manually feeding it biometric data. This is still a prototype. This is a pivotal moment in modern conflict solution, Ted. Pallas is entirely foolproof. All you need is to pick a photo from the table.
Target acquired. Shit. Robert Knox.
Aw, oh, shit.
Hello there, sir.
What the hell?
Robert Knox down. Now for the heir to the Kronstadt Empire.
Greetings, sir.
With Sierra Knox over at the hotel. Yeah, after the race. I just got to pick up the documents from my van, but I had to knock out a guy and steal his flamingo outfit, and now I can't find my car keys. Yeah, I know it's dumb. I think I lost them in the scuffle, but the real mascot is still over there. If I don't get them, I've got no evidence. Bye-bye money. I don't know. I need to figure something out. I'll talk soon. Keys are over there. The guy's crazy and I don't dare go over there, but you look pretty tough. Please.
Oh man, where are my clothes? Have you seen my mascot outfit? Oh, my head is killing me.
Did you find some keys over there? Oh man, you're a real lifesaver, thank you!
Thank you.
The race is entering its final lap, 47.
Safe as houses. Bit of high voltage never did it. Anyone any harm, right? Up and running.
47, the race is over. Sierra will be coming off the track any time now.
Hydration boost, normally reserved for the drivers. Fixed me right up.
What, like doping?
No, it's for after the race and stuff.
Although, it kind of looks like the board of friends.
Hey, I really want to tell you by the other man. I ran away fast. Will you go with you and me?
Well, I don't know. I really don't want to get involved. I've got a lot of unpaid traffic.
That's not looking good.
Weird.
That thing's beyond fixing.
Stands were over there on the left side of the entrance. If you want to try the food,
Blue Sea, ladies and gentlemen, sponsor of the Global Innovation Race. Headache, hair loss, depression. Blue Sea brings you high-quality pharmaceuticals. prices you can afford.
Oh my.
Listen to yourself. I know I have the tickets. I just need to find them.
Hey! I've been looking forward to this event.
How can a grown man degrade himself like that? I mean, look at that costume.
This is a race that will go down in history. Unforgettable drama.
I'm sorry, but
what more could anyone possibly
want? Sir.
Let's hear it for our champion. And let's get the
I need some help here.
Started.
Hey, you. What seems to be the problem here?
There's this guy. Right now. I think it's right there. Okay, step back. I'll go and check.
Was a hell of a...
Hey, you! What are you doing wandering around where you're not allowed?
That is Sierra Knox, reckless daredevil with a violent temper. Quite the handful, as I understand it.
Shoot the fuck!
Christ, somebody help me!
During a pit stop yesterday, and it looks so futuristic in there.
Almost. That guy, Trevor Jones, he's not just a race driver.
Fire away! Get that killer shot to impress his family and friends.
Hey, what's up?
goddamn super glue or something?
Huh?
Crap, what a mess. Who'd do something like that? Man, that thing's beyond fixing.
You, this is not a place. Hey, I could.
That stuff anyway.
I think some of the teams are using it to increase car speed. Heard a few Kronstadt mechanics talking about it the other day. Something about Knox not wanting to use it because she wants to win.
That's not looking good.
I'm telling you, Miss Knox is going to be pissed.
I did the pre-race checkup on her and...
Well, let's just say she's got a bad case of sleep.
How are you, sir?
Mr. Durant, that's crazy.
Ah, yeah. Jesus Christ, that's gonna hurt.
So did Dr. Sorensen manage to get Sierra Knox's phone number? I heard him arguing with that Kronstadt lawyer earlier.
No, didn't have any luck. Once he's done with that other guy. I hear it just fine.
All right. As long as it's in hand.
Yeah.
Ugh, please go away. You're so not in my league.
Paging Miss Sierra Knox. The doctor will see you now.
Oh, doctor. God, I'm so happy to see you. I'm guessing you're here to replace Dr. Sorensen. I forget your name, sorry?
Dr. Reaper.
Ah, yes, of course. Well, whenever you're ready, you can page Miss Knox. I know she's very eager to get her vitamin boost.
I'll prepare for her arrival.
Yes?
I'm Sierra Knox. You paged me. I have an appointment.
God, I hope I
can just take a seat, please. Oh, great.
Miss Knox, I'm ready for you.
Let's do this. All right, Doug. Where'd you want me?
Miss Knox. Come on in. Have a seat and relax.
So, what's on the menu? Something that'll take care of this hideous pain in my neck, I hope.
I promise. Once I'm done, you won't feel a thing.
So what's in this thing anyway, Doc?
Mostly floral extracts, hemlock, belladonna, aconite. It's designed to be fast and efficient.
Fast and efficient. I like that. I
think you're coming on a bit strong there.
Belladonna?
I just don't
Isn't that poisonous?
Yes.
Should I be concerned?
Back off, okay?
I'm not. Just relax. It'll be over soon.
So what exactly are we waiting for here? I don't have all day. Hey, you know what? I do feel refreshed. Thanks, Doc.
My pleasure, Miss Knox.
Oh, God! I gotta call my dermatologist back.
I don't feel well, Doctor.
Don't worry. It'll be over soon, Miss Knox.
Both targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.
Berlin. Shanghai. Montreal. We're bleeding operatives. Panic is spreading, and now we are axing our own?
Knox was a traitor. He would have caused incalculable damage.
And he won't be the last. This is exactly what the enemy wants. We need to fight the sickness, not the symptom.
And I have just the tool for the job.
Right. The Burnwood woman. Eric Soders warned you about her, didn't he? The Crusader.
I can handle Miss Burnwood. Everyone hates power until you offer them some.
You ought to know.
ICA speaks the enemy's language. We need them.
And once we don't?
We'll cross that bridge when we get there.
Fact remains, we are shadowboxing. We need to know who we are up against.
is good.
My life.
Long couple of months.
Yeah, it's a good situation. Miss Yamazaki's very smart, very capable.
But hey!
Maybe you can tell me, is it true the boss...
What up?
You know, even with the added security, this is the most relaxing gig I've been on with Ms. Yamazaki yet.
Makes me miss the old days, to be honest.
Oof, not me. I'm pretty happy she got out of the clan business. Things got hairy around that whole trial of the century thing, remember?
Oh, sure. The work was dirty from time to time, but this new approach with consultant work, I don't know. Feels light.
Well, I prefer light to heavy. If heavy involves dissolving witnesses in acid baths before noon, oof, just doesn't do it for me anymore.
That was an interesting afternoon, yeah.
Check that out.
Loud and clear. Bravo, Zulu.
6 moving in on possible enemy target. Over.
Mr. Jason Portman, please come to the hospital entrance. A doctor will escort you to your checkup. That was for Mr. Jason Portman. A doctor will escort you to your appointment. Please proceed to the hospital entrance.
What?
Use a bloody trash can.
That is Yuki Yamazaki, former lawyer to the Yakuza and current operative for Providence.
What's this?
Who dropped that?
If I actually had my cigarettes, I would be very displeased.
Hey, what?
Don't!
Target down. Now it's time for Sodas to retire.
Maybe you can tell me, is it true the boss was connected back in the day?
My son is a painter. I told you that, right? He's doing quite well. But anyway, he's always saying that... I'll tell you something. We're up here. It's beautiful.
We should enjoy it and not worry about what's going on in the rest of the world.
Spa earlier with an entourage of bodyguards. Yeah, I had to leave.
You're kidding me.
That's a little harsh, isn't it? A total ban?
I don't know. Aquariums always fill me with such calm. Looking at the beautiful fish, just serene in their simple existence. It takes the stress right out of me.
What's up?
Chin up, chest out.
It's me.
That is the right-sided donor heart destined for Sodas. This is what he sold out the ICA for.
Hey! Someone, please help me!
No.
Solution 47, with Sodas on the operating table, and no hope of getting a second right-sided heart in time, you have effectively killed him without laying a hand on him. This should be a clear message to anyone considering following in his footsteps. That's both targets down. Time to find an exit. We're done here.
we?
You got
through.
Listen, I want to talk to the partners directly. Make them understand why all of this is happening. And that terminal gives me an idea. There's a server room near the Sheikh's personal reception. If you can gain access to it, we might be able to recover useful intel from it. We'll have to work together to hack the system, but it's our best shot. It looks like the staff area could provide you with a viable route to the server room. There's a keypad lock on the doors to the staff area. One moment. All right, try this. 4706. There's quite a bit of security here. One moment. You ready for some more fresh air, 47?
Says everyone working triple shifts. There's so much concern.
What?
I think I can open that window remotely. Scan the lock with your camera and I'll have a try.
Come on, what the? Oh, no, not now. Oh, what a freaking waste of time.
Sheikh Al-Ghazali is reaching out to his worldwide network of lawyers and financial contacts, attempting to restore the lost power base of the Providence Partners. If Ingram and Stuyvesant were asked to a meeting, thinking they'll be told of new developments, I suspect they'd jump at the chance. There's a lounge area at the top of the building. It can be sealed off for private conversations. If we lure the targets there, they'll be trapped. Server room should be behind one of the doors in this hallway.
Hello?
Yeah, I just want to remind you about the
calendar function. We can use this to summon the partners to a fake meeting, 47. All right, I'm no hacker like Olivia, but I think you need to pull one of the racks here to gain access to the terminal. Silent alarm has been tripped. Security is on its way. Hide, 47.
Of course, it's all fine.
This is out.
Hey, you! Show me those hands! I'm gonna have to take you with me.
Okay.
Oi, you, drop the weapon right now!
Forty-seven, reinforcements are incoming. More guards on their way.
Affirmative. So lucky one, actually. Bagging and tagging any bodies found.
Looks like we've been compromised. All units, give me a sit rep. Control over.
I just want to check something, sir. You know you'll get hurt acting like that.
Fire.
Oh, no! Someone be you. Come on, switch on. We've got trouble.
Oh, no, you don't! Drop the rifle! Understand?
Right there! He's in there!
Drop it! Just do it! Deadly force is authorized. Engage when ready. Don't let him get away!
Got it.
Just fine. Oh, damn IT guys and their stupid equipment. I'm sick of coming down here.
System online.
Yes, sorry about that, 47. Let's try again, shall we? I think I've got it. We'll need a key card to gain access. Someone in maintenance should have one we can borrow for a spell.
I thought about what you said. Yeah, I changed my mind. It was an insane idea to start with. Exploding golf balls. I don't want blood in my hands.
Please! Please, no!
Must have done something. Can you see anything different in the room? Seven guards are heading your way. Be careful.
System failure.
online.
Guards are heading your way. Be careful. Seven guards are heading your way. Be careful. Good. We're in. Now all you need to do is access the terminal and use the calendar option to summon the Providence partners to a meeting. Good work. The meeting has been booked. The partners should be moving up here shortly. Huh. Looks like the lounge can be sealed off for private conversations. Handy. Excellent. I see the partners moving. You should join their meeting. Time to end this, 47.
Yes. Hello, sir.
It's a hell of a uniform you got there, guy.
You know the guest grumpy one always wants peace and quiet. Yeah, I haven't seen him playing golf today. You must be.
Partners are alone now. I'll activate the panel controlling the room's security features. When you're ready, use it to start the show.
What did you do?
I kicked his door in, put a gun in his face. Told him if he didn't like noise, he could pack his shit, move out to the desert.
That was a bit brutal. Did he move?
Nah, he's my brother-in-law. My wife persuaded him to stay. He hasn't complained since.
Sounds cozy.
Where's the Sheik?
It's a busy day for him. Surely we can give him a few.
No. What's this? Carl? Did you do that?
I certainly did not. I have no... idea what's going on.
Don't hit me!
Ah! Oh, shit!
Not a patient man, are you? Finally, Stuyvesant and Ingram are gone. Providence will soon be no more than a bad memory. 47. Thank you. I'll meet you at the rendezvous on the edge of town.
Thank you.
Where is he? Where's the Sheik?
It's a busy day for it. Surely we can give him a few moments.
Do you know what he wants to talk about?
Wait! Move! I need help!
No!
Oh, okay, well done. I guess. Finally, Stuyvesant and Ingram are gone.
Where is he? Where's the Sheik?
It's a busy day for him. Surely we can give him.
Unexpectedly fast. Finally, Stuyvesant and Ingram are gone. Provident.
Where is he? Where's the Sheik?
It's a busy day for him. Surely we can give him a few moments.
Do you know what he wants to talk about?
No, but please vacate the room. This is a private conversation.
Don't even think of it! Need to get up. Where's don't hit me?
Not a patient man, are you? Finally, Stuyvesant and Ingram are gone. Providence will soon be no more than a bad memory. 47. Thank you. I'll meet you at the rendezvous on the edge of town.